How many guys didn't get their laundry done after this song came out?
What a pussy.
He said to
He's ruining it for all of us.
Yes.
The clip they showed from the interview on last time, Fuglesang's show, he said, like, the people that got mad at him, Lennon, he goes, yeah, there was people that got mad at me, but they were, like, white and mostly men.
Like, oh, really?
That was who, of course, got mad at him.
What a weird influence Yoko had on him, though.
Yeah.
Really strange.
I probably told him to write that song while he was worshiping her feet.
Right? You write a woman in need of love.
Yeah.
All right.
There's a great YouTube bit going on. It's been going on for a little while. Yoko did like a performance at a museum.
Oh, it's terrible.
And, yeah, thanks, Jay. It's Jay _ Giordano on Twitter. He's a good one. I like his tweets. He tweeted the YouTube clip of Yoko doing pop songs. It's a little bit that's going on YouTube. And I don't understand why people fucking take her so fucking seriously for all these years.
Because she fucked John Lennon, period.
It's just a letter J, not spell out J. Yeah, but she walks up to the microphone and just starts screaming. And I guess, you know, you can't question what art is. I understand that.
Yeah.
But it's garbage. But it's
pure,
garbage.
Pure
but you know garbage when you see it, right?
Yes.
But others would say, well, that's, you know, it's garbage to you. It's art to blue.
There's nothing.
That's what I start hearing.
There's nothing thought-provoking or moving or anything. It's just annoying. It's like then a tire screeching on pavement is art.
All right, so it's art, but let's get some different categories in the art world.
Yeah, there's shit art.
That's shit art.
And she's doing shit art.
I will stand behind the duty hat being way more something I would love to see in a museum before Yoko Ono.
Yeah.
Stepping up to the microphone and just screaming. So they took her screaming. And it's a little YouTube bit that's been going on for a while. And now what you get here is Yoko Ono covering the Adele song Someone Like You, which is a beautiful song by Adele with that lovely voice of hers.
Wonderful.
And this is Yoko's interpretation. At an art museum. Standing up against the wall. Yoko's going to dramatically walk up to the microphone. Here she goes. There's no one here, by the way.
Just like Corey Feldman. It's amazing, right?
Jeez.
This is infuriating to watch.
It's embarrassing. Do.
I Well, why is it infuriating? There's way better artists that don't get any fucking attention.
She's talentless.
She really, she is a fucking zilch.
That's her version of Adele.
It's just
Can you play
garbage,
her version
right.
of Firecracker? That one's really good.
The Firecracker's better, though. I mean, I didn't love it, but it's better than this.
Firecracker. She does a great performance of Firecracker by Katy Perry.
But you're right. It's utter garbage. That's it's garbage.
Fireworks. What did I say? Firecracker. Oh, Firecracker. Fireworks, of course.
Oh.
What?
There you go. I know this song.
Yeah. She does a much better job of this one. Another Yoko Ono cover.
All she did was fuck Lennon.
You're right, Jimmy. This one's way better.
Way better.
She's nervous ticking.
Yeah. You think it's written or she's making it up as she goes along?
A little bit about that. And everybody watching is thinking she stinks. And yet
yes.
No one has the balls to go, you blow.
An empty room with one mic in the middle that she steps up to.
This dramatically.
Pompous
yes.
idiot.
Yeah, she's a pompous idiot. Screaming.
That's how stupid the art world is.
Yeah.
That's how dumb they are.
Well, not really. I mean, the people, there's not many people there and they're laughing at her.
She walks through a crowd, though, after this. I've seen this.
There was a little press conference, I guess, that she was going to do this Katy Perry song.
Yeah.
Too bad she didn't scream like this outside the Dakota before it all went down, because Mark David Chapman would have dropped the gun and run.
Right.
And ran. Excuse me. Does she cover any other songs, Sam?
Oh, she's fucking...
What else does she cover?
Treacherously bad.
Oh, this will be a good one.
Which one she covers?
I'm Sexy and I Know It by LMFAO.
Oh, let's see how she covers that one.
Something a little more dancey.
Yeah.
Well, she's got range.
Oh, yeah.
We all know this song. Let's see how she does it.
Sounds like fireworks.
It does. She's obviously, like, was married to a very talented guy, and she looks at him as like, oh, he sings and plays music. I would love to do that, but I have no talent whatsoever, so I'm just going to warble.
But he placated to her, and she took over the stage.
She's a bellowing idiot.
She completely influenced the guy, to the point he brings her around for that super fucking band thing they did.
And she wrecks one of those songs, a few of those songs.
You got to find that. I thank Jay Moore to this day for turning me on to Rock and Roll Circus, an amazing documentary where everyone is really fucked up and they're wearing rain slickers in the audience.
Yeah.
And then at the end, they did a huge over-the-top jam. And Yoko Ono was included and ruined the whole fucking thing.
Yep.
And nobody respects her artistically.
But
nobody.
No one said, hey, John, how about you tell her no this time?
Nobody.
John never told her no. Do you got it?
She'd been slapped on the nose and told no like a dog.
We've played it a few times in the past, and we have found the video.
I have the audio.
The video is pretty amazing, though, because you could see everyone is just fucked up, tripping their faces off.
My nose itchy.
Rock and Roll Circus, it's called. Right, okay. You got Keith Richards. We've got John Lennon. I think Ian Anderson is there. Look at them. They're all wearing this rain shit in the audience.
He's going to bring that lump with him. He's a dick for doing it, too.
Of course.
Really is.
That's fucking rocking the fiddle.
Right.
Yeah.
Crazy.
Yeah.
They're all fucking stoned. Yeah. They're all out of tune.
Right. Look at Keith Richards in the back.
You know how annoyed people must have been to see her get up on her dumb fucking ring?
John Lennon. I think you got someone from Hendrix up there.
And Yoko's just standing on the stage.
She's valueless. And this is not even a good jam, to be honest with you.
I'm not sure if this is the one.
Jam is terrible.
You know, this is... Thanks.
As on the violin.
Yeah, beat it.
Uh-oh, Yoko's trying to get on the mic.
Look at her just kind of stand there, fucking arms
trying to get on mic. Oh, John just fucking went like this. Did you see? His head went, go ahead, get on mic.
Can you rewind that?
Like, he's fucking...
Yeah, he liked what she did. Go back a little bit.
Watch what he does. Watch, look at this. She looks at him at one point, and he's like, go. Watch. Look,
he
go.
Says go.
Yeah, but he kind of shrugs like, go.
I would have a headache if this was.
Look at that. Holy fuck.
And Lennon. Yeah.
I know there's other guys up there, too.
Oh. Jesus Christ. Are you kidding me? The fiddle player's laughing now.
Ruining everything.
Yes.
Right. Is that Eric Clapton?
Does Clapton have to deal with this shit?
Might have been that cock blocker.
You guys trying to play fiddle louder?
Yeah.
Trying to drown her out.
She's just screaming. The fiddle guy, like, what is this fucking bitch doing?
Yeah, there's a fucking short cousin in who's making noise next to me. Are you done running, bouncing and enjoying it? That stone moron.
Look, they're all laughing.
They're all laughing too.
What an abomination.
She sucks. I wonder if this was also Lennon was just so disinterested at this point, all this adulation he was getting. It's like he was bored.
She thinks she's doing something here.
She's not contributing to this at all. She's ruining it.
Anyone could do that.
Oh, you should fucking take that fiddle bow and just start beating her over the head.
You'd be out of jail already. What a healer
yes.
You'd be.
What an asshole John Lennon was.
Yeah.
What just an asshole. To even allow this. Get your chick off the stage.
Yeah. But if you wanted him, you had to tolerate him.
It's half over, by the way. It just keeps going and going. And
yeah, that is Clapton.
And so you got Clapton, you got Keith Richards, you got John Lennon. I don't recognize the drummer, but I'm sure he's from...
Hendrix or something like that.
Yeah, yeah.
Experience.
Yeah, every guy up there is a superstar in the rock world. And then you got Yoko Ono.
He brings his fucking chick.
Oh. Jesus, how embarrassing.
He brings his blood. This is going to be like me fucking fighting at the Juggalos.
Like, this is the best they could come up with, having all that talent on one stage. You know?
I'm just looking at all the subtleties in this. Like, at one point, Clapton just gazed over at Keith Richards like, what the fuck?
Why did we agree to this?
And now she's smiling like she just did something huge. And these stoned assholes don't know what they're fucking clapping at.
Oh, look at her just standing there trying to be part of the mix.
It's infuriating, right? All these years later.
She doesn't deserve to fucking lick the boots of anyone on that stage.
It's called Rock and Roll Circus. Jay Moore, a long time ago, turned me on to it. It's a great
documentary.
It's so fucking weird.
They should call it a circus because it's a whole bunch of just tricksters.
Obi and Anthony Show. The Obi and Anthony Show. Sirius XM.